And power crews there are racing against the clock to clean up debris and restore power before more bad weather that is forecasted for the area moves in. And it is equally grim in Westchester County, where more than 13,000 Con Ed customers still do not have electricity. Charles Perez is in White Plains tonight, and he continues our coverage. Charles.
You said it, Liz. Those 13,000 woke up this morning still without power. And the reason, Con Ed, is what you see behind me. Power poles literally split in two. Electric wires not only ripped from the poles, but often tangled, needing to be untangled, or often, like the poles, completely replaced.
Blocking roads, ripping down trees, passing out blocks of dry ice, Con Ed out and about, getting the power back on and trying to ease the pain of a power outage that has backed up traffic and left many more than inconvenienced. Andy Batten's 85-year-old mother-in-law had to be moved out when the electric went out. How bad was it?
Close to life-threatening for her, because without the nebulizer, she gets in trouble.
At P&D's Italian restaurant, where the power just went back on, they paid a price.
We lost a lot of money yesterday, but today I guess we're going to make up for what we lost yesterday.
Now, for many, this inconvenience, according to Con Ed, will not end until Sunday. This is County Exec Andy Spano says he wants to take this power outage, the recent tornado, the recent flooding, put them all together for the purpose of getting federal disaster relief. Live in White Plains, I'm Charles Perez, Channel 7, Eyewitness News.
Charles, thank you very much, and stay with Eyewitness News for the very latest on the power problems. We are waiting Mayor Bloomberg, who is supposed to have a news conference in Queens. Soon as he steps to the podium, we will bring that to you live. If you have any video or photos of storm damage, by the way, you can send them to us at eyewitness@abc.com.
And while we wait for the mayor's news conference, we will continue with Eyewitness News at 6 for this Thursday night. Police say they have arrested a